So hello everyone, today I will like to talk about success. So what it takes to succeed, what do you require to be successful? So there are many things said, that some says luck plays a very important role, some people say hard work is very important. So many things are said about success. So before going to that, I will like to play a game with you. So we'll play a game. So we have alphabets from A to Z and we will give them numbers. Like A is 1, B is 2, C is 3, D is 4 and so on. And by that game, we will like to see how much contribution, what factors make in your success. So like most of the people say, luck. Luck plays an important role in success. So we'll like to see how much contribution the luck plays. So if we write the luck and according to our L is 12, U is 21, C is 3, K is 11. So the total it comes out to be 47%. So that means luck is not a major role. Even 50% is not played by luck. So luck is not that important. Then we target the knowledge. We say that we should be knowledgeable to be successful. So we see the knowledge and if we add all these, it comes out to 96%. So that means quite a good. So you must be knowledgeable to get the success, which is very important. Then we do the hard work. And if we find out, the hard work contributes 98%. If you do the hard work, you have 98% chance of being successful. But still, you have not achieved 100%. So you 100% you need success. And that 100% can only come from your attitude. So this is very, very important. You can be successful only if you have a good attitude. If you want to be successful, you must have an attitude to be successful. Yeah? You have to think that I have to do this thing, only then you can do. If you can think that whether I will be successful or not, you will never be. Yeah? So attitude must always be there. Without attitude, you cannot be successful. And you can learn from the story of this female Arunima Sinha. You know about her?
No.
Yes, she was a simple female from a small village of Uttar Pradesh, UP. She was going by a train. Some robbers came. They snatched her things and also threw her out of the train, moving train. So she was there on the platform, on the track, whole of the night. Her both legs were broken. She was there for whole night. No person came to her rescue. And the insects were present on her skin, and in the morning someone noted her and took her to AIIMS. So when she reached the AIIMS, it was found that her both legs need to be cut. She cannot walk, she cannot do anything. So what a normal person will think in these circumstances? So obviously they will think the life is waste, he cannot do anything now. But what she thought? She thought that I did not die, I am alive, I must be alive because of some reason. So I will do something great. So she thought that I must do something great with my life because I am survived. So then she go and she climbed all the mountains, not only Mount Everest, all the seven tops of the world. So this is the attitude. Had she thought like most of the people that my life is worthless now, she would not have done anything. So now she have climbed all the tops of the world, including the Mount Everest. That is all because of her attitude. So that is the message to me, that you should have always a positive attitude. And without attitude, you cannot do anything. So attitude is must. Our greatest strength lies in weakness. Giving up. Yeah? So giving up should never be an option. So remember, you can try the story of keys. Like we have a bunch of keys. You want to open a lock. So you try the first, the lock doesn't open, second lock doesn't open. So what, one key will come when the lock will open, clear? So you should always keep on searching for that key. So giving up is not an option, giving up should never be an option. So that is very important. So my take home message is, giving up is never an option. If you think you can, you can. If you think you cannot. And either way, you are always right. So my take home message is, you should always have positive attitude and never give. Thank you.